Some people say in order to get good band in IELTS writing, you should use advanced vocabulary. How far is that true or not true? Okay, in IELTS writing, there are four marking criteria. You all know about that. The first one is task response. Task response is, if they ask you to write the story of Thirsty Crow, you're not writing Greedy Dog. Yeah, so task response means whatever the topic of the essay is, you are writing according to that topic. Task response. It means 250 words for task 2, 150 words for task 1 and all that. Second criteria is grammatical range and accuracy. We'll talk about that later. And one criteria is coherence and cohesion. Now, lexical resource is the criteria, which is what we call vocabulary. Okay, now two things, try to understand my point. One thing is you have topic related vocabulary. They give you topic on education, so you should know some words which are related to education. For example, they give you topic that is crime, you should know some words related to crime. They give you topic foreign education, so you should know some words for that. That is what I call topic related vocabulary. Second one is what I say essay type related vocabulary. Now, what is essay type related vocabulary? You are writing an opinion essay. In opinion essay, there are five paragraphs. In each paragraph, there are number of sentences which you have to write, and there are some specific words which you must write. And these words are around 50 to 60 words. Right? For example, you're writing advantages, disadvantages essay. Now, you must use the words advantages, benefits, drawbacks, pros and cons and all that. That is what I call type-related vocabulary. Now, type-related vocabulary, you guys can cram, ratta. Opinion essay mein ye 50 words honay honay use. Right? Problem solution essay mein problem ke liye 5-6 words. Solution ke liye 5-6 words. And then we've got coherence and cohesion. First of all, secondly, finally, ye wo vocabulary hai which you can learn easily. And it should be on your fingertips. When I write my introduction, I'll use this. Now, the second vocabulary, which is what you are talking, that is what we say topic-related vocabulary. In IELTS, if you read the band descriptor, you can find it on Google. They have mentioned for 8-band, this is the quality. These things should be there for 8-band. For 7-band, this is the criteria. So you can find it on Google band descriptor. Now, coming back to that, for actually high band score, they don't see that you are using high-5 vocabulary. If you're using high-5 vocabulary and those words are not related to the topic, but you try to put those words forcefully, acha word hai, acha band score mil jayega, that will go against that. There is one criteria, irrelevant, and one criteria is actually crammed answer. So if you write anything irrelevant to the topic, whether that is one sentence, that is going to be out of word count. If you're going to write irrelevant sentence, that will be out of word count. Now, if you try to use high-5 vocabulary, instead of giving you good band, that will give you low band. Why? Because sometimes you don't know the function of the word. Sometimes you don't know the contextual meaning of the word. So if you use that word, that I know the word, 18 alphabet ke spelling hai, maine ratta bhi lagaya, I have to put this word somewhere, so that will be wrong. Okay, use synonyms, variety of words. Synonyms, I mean, that is the key to success in IELTS, number one. Number two, collocations. Now, what are collocations? Group of words which are used together by native speakers. Now, what are those group of words? Important decision. Important and decision. Crucial stage. Crucial and stage. We call this thing, actually, this is what we call collocations. So use collocations, use synonyms which are related to topic. Now, for example, they give you a topic about education. You further define education like school, colleges, universities. For education, you can talk about students. You can talk about other things which are just related to that. So once you use appropriate words and the words are simple, you will get good band score. In order to finish this answer, I would tell you one thing. One of my students, I think from Multan, without any preparation, he got 6 band in IELTS. 6.5, I guess. Yeah. And he was overjoyed and very, very happy. Sir, without any preparation, 6.5 band, And now I'm going to work hard and I'll take my IELTS test again. And inshallah, next time with preparation, I'll get 7 band. He did 1 month intensive training on YouTube. He watched many videos. He learned high five vocabulary and all that. After a month, appeared in IELTS test again, writing band 5.5. And he was like, main IELTS walon pe case kar dunga. Main ye kar dunga. 5.5 with full preparation. 6.5 without preparation. So if you are going in the wrong direction while doing your preparation, you are making a plan for the low band score. Right? What he did, he forced some flowery words. Like on YouTube, you will find 7 band vocabulary, 8 band vocabulary, 9 band vocabulary, something like that. So if you use irrelevant words like that, then instead of increasing your band score, those words will be the reason for the low band score. Right? Okay, thank you.